Hello my dear students, today in this video we will discuss the topic crisis of the 14th century. In this topic we will discuss that what were the problems which were there in Europe during the 14th century. As in the previous video students, we have discussed that during the 11th century there was a lot of changes which were there in Europe, and those changes like the climatic condition change. Because of the change in the climatic condition, the crop production increased, in which led to the expansion of the trade in Europe. So those changes were there, but after here and now 11th century, now this is 14th century, means after 300 years around, again there were a changes in the climate in Europe, and these changes were negative, and those things led to the 14th century crisis, means the problems which were there during the 14th century, which led to the economic downfall in Europe. So student, by the early 14th century, economic expansion which was started during the 11th century slowed down in Europe. Why? Because by the end of the 13th century, warm summers changed into bitter cold summer. Earlier, you know that there was so much cold weather which was there in Europe, but that cold season changed into a warmer one. But again now the summers had become so cold, and because of that change in the climatic condition, again the season of the growing of the crops reduced, because now again the larger time period, during a large time period, the land get covered with the snow because of the cold weather. And because of this, it became, because of the cold weather, it also became difficult to grow a crop on a higher ground, on a higher altitude, because you know at a higher altitude there was a cold, the cold weather means the temperature reduced more. And at the lower side, at the lower ground, there was a problem of storms and the oceanic flood, which destroy many farms areas, which keep on destroying the crops. And because of all these problems, it was difficult to grow on the higher altitude as well as at so much lower altitude. As the result, the crop production reduced because of this unfavorable condition. Favorable condition earlier resulted in large scale reclamation of land, of forest and pasture. Earlier when the climatic condition became favorable for the agriculture, obviously there was a lot of clearance of the forest land and the pasture land, and that land, forest land and pasture land, was converted into an agricultural land. But in, because of the conversion of the pasture land into an agricultural land, the land available for the as a fodder for the animals also reduced, and this resulted now at this time during the 14th century into the death of a large number of animals, and this increased the number of animals. And obviously when the number of animals reduced, then it will adversely affect the agriculture also, because agriculture at that time depend on animals. And because of so much production, the extensive plowing was there, turning of the soil was there, and this extensive plowing exhausted the fertility of the soil, and this thing also resulted in the less crop production. So student, this is the first crisis, 14th century crisis, was the change in the climatic condition. Our climatic condition became warm, from warmest to the colder, and because of the this cold climatic condition, the crop production reduced because of various reasons. Okay, now the second crisis was that of the trade. Trade was hitted strongly because of the shortage of metal currency, because now you know, as I told you, as the trade expanded, the transaction of the goods was done through the currency, through the money, metallic money. But there was, during the 14th century, there was a shortage of metal money. Why there was a shortage of metal money? Because the metal money, especially the metal which was used in the currency, was the silver, and that silver was supplied from the mines of Austria and Serbia. But during the 14th century, what happened? There was a shortfall in the outcome of the mine from these mines. Means during the mining, the output of the silver from these mines reduced during the 14th century. And because of this reduction in the output, obviously there was a shortage of silver, and now government have to make some cheaper metal in the coins used. That's why this had the adverse effect on the trade of during the 14th century. Okay, so the second crisis was that of the shortage of the metal money. Now the third crisis, this is more severe than these, because the third crisis was that known as the Black Death. Black Death means the large number of death occurred during the 14th century because of the spread of a plague disease, an epidemic disease, plague, because of the coming of rat into Europe. And how these rat came, as you know, the trade expanded. The ships from Europe goes to other countries or other continent to bring the goods and to carry carrying the good. And through these ships, the rats, so many rats come in Europe, at the port of Europe. And because of that, the trading center, the main trading center in Europe, get hard hit by those, because those rats carried with them the epidemic disease called plague. And because this disease impact all the section of the population, including the infant, younger one, and the adult one, means senior citizens. And if anyone get infected because of this disease, no one will survive. The one who get infected because of infected of this plague cannot be survived. Means the disease was so much severe. And because of this disease, this epidemic spread mainly during the time period of from 1347 to 1350. The effect of this epidemic was so much severe. Although later also the plague disease spread from 1360s to the 70s, but at this time it was not that much severe as it was during the time period 1347 to 1350. You can understood the intensity of the severity of the disease from here, that the mortality rate of Europe, mortality rate means the number of deaths, was from 20 to 40%. Means in this because of this disease, 20 to 40% of the European population get finished up because of this. And as the trade center hit it, firstly the trade center hit it because the ships came at those trading center, and later on it spread to other parts like that of the monasteries and the convent. They were also get so hard hit because of the disease. Why monasteries? You know, a monastery is a place where the monks live. Monks, the person, the preachers who preaches the Christianity religion by moving from one place to another, who did not marry. Okay, so these monasteries, in these monasteries, you know, many people live together, and if one get infected because of this plague, then from that one person, it is spread to the all the persons who were living in that monastery, and all get finished up, all died, because the disease was so much severe. Okay, so first crisis was that of the climatic condition, second of the shortage of the metal money, and third was more severe, that was the Black Death. Now come to the last one, fourth crisis during the 14th century was that of the economic crisis. Because of all these three things led to the third crisis, that was the economic crisis. Because large number of population of Europe got finished up because of the Black Death, you can understood from here, during the 13th century the population of Europe was 73 million, and in 100 years till the 1400 it reduced to 45 million. There was so much reduction in the population of Europe, and because of this reduction of the population, there was a shortage of labor in Europe. And when you know something is in shortage, then obviously their prices rises. So same occur in Europe. Because of the shortage of the labor, the wage rate of these laborers increased so much. and it increased so much in the as the wages of the agricultural laborers especially increased so much because the agricultural laborers were so less and the demand was so much because of the during the agricultural season, during the main season, their demand was so much. That's why their wage increased so much, increased from double to triple with the wage which was there of the labor earlier before the 14th century. From that, after the 14th century, during the 14th century, it got three times from that. And first thing, the wage rate increase of the labor because of the shortage of the labor, because of the decrease of the population. And second thing which occurred was the prices of the good, prices of the agriculture crops also reduced. Why it get reduced? Because now the population reduced, and as the population reduced, the demand also reduced. And when you know the demand of any thing reduced, as the result, it prices also fall. So this thing led to the economic crisis in EU. So student, all these are the four problems which led to the 14th century crisis. And all these things led to the condition of a social unrest in Europe. There was a social unrest. There was a problematic condition in Europe because of all these things. Why? Because of all these problems, the income of the lord. Lord, you know, lord was the one, means the head, a big landowner who give the land to the peasant also to grow. So the income of this lord reduced. Why the income of lord reduced? You know, because of these two reasons. Reduce of the crop, prices of the crops. And second thing, increase of the wage of the labor. Now they have to pay more and they get as a income less. That's why the income of these lord reduced. And by the reduction of their income, they get so desperate, these lords became so desperate that they want to revive the previous economic system. What was the previous economic system? The economic system which was there before the 11th century. Means after the 11th century, you know, when the trade expanded, the agriculture, the surplus production was there, and because of that the trade expanded, then the economy became more money oriented. Means the flow of money increased in the economy. Earlier, the peasant have to give the labor service to the lord. But now, after the 11th century, as I told you in the previous video, now labor pay the money to these lord. So during this time, after the 14th century, now lord again want to try to give up the money contract and revive the labor service because it was more beneficial for them. But the laborers, the agricultural laborers were not ready, or the peasants were not ready to move again to the previous system of the laborhood. That's why they started revolting against the lord. And the revolt, the intensity of revolt was so much in those areas where the after the 11th century, the economic expansion was more. The more economically prosperous region have the more severe revolt. And all these things led to the lord a kind of a means the lord get worried so much, and because of that they now started to crush these revolt done by the peasant. Although the revolt done by the peasant was crushed brutally by the lord, but the lord can't be able to revive the previous system. What was the previous system? The previous feudal privileges which they had. One of the feudal privilege which these lord had was the collection of the taxation. They imposed various kind of taxation on peasant, as well as the peasant have to give the labor service. All these things lord tried to revive, but till now the economy goes so far that they can't be able, the lord can't be able to revive that system. Now the economy remained the money based. The peasant ensured that the previous system don't get revived. So student, in this video we discuss two things. One is the crisis of the 14th century, and second, what after these crises, what were the social unrest condition which was there in Europe. Thank you all.